The opinions expressed in the following program are not necessarily those of Eastlink TV, its sponsors, or partners.
Hi, I'm Nancy Summers, scientist here at Science North, and I'm here to talk more about 3D printing. Last week I told you all about choosing a design, and once you choose a design, there's some things that you need to think about. So one of those things is if you choose a design that is a 3D object, you want to make sure that you design it so that it is not solid inside, but really strong on the outside. So like my Yoda, he's really strong on the outside, but he's very lightweight, so he's hollow on the inside. If he were, well, sort of hollow, and I'll tell you what I mean. If he were totally hollow, he wouldn't be very strong. But if the walls were really made thick, you would think that he would be strong like this ball. So if I squish this ball, it's really, really hard and strong. But actually, the ball inside is very hollow. And it is made of a whole bunch of squares and triangles to give it strength. But to use, the purpose of this is to use the least amount of plastic possible, because the plastic is actually very expensive. So you want to make things as efficient as possible. The most efficient thing that we found is this shape here. It's the hexagon shape. Now you might recognize this hexagon shape from nature. Bees use it and so do wasps. So to tell us a little bit more about that, I'm going to invite our staff scientist, biologist, Jenny Fortier. Hi, Jenny.
Hi, Nancy. Thanks. Awesome. So this hexagon shape is seen quite often in nature, especially in honeybees and wasps. So if you take a look at a frame of honeybee comb, I've just got a piece of a frame here, you can see that each of these little cells is what we call them. They're made of hexagons, just like our 3D printed materials. And the hexagon is a great material for bees because if they're going to repetitively make a structure, the hexagon is the best because they need the least material for the walls.
The least material, and that's exactly what we wanted to do here.
Exactly. So while you're saving plastic for your 3D printer, they're actually saving the amount of wax that they have to produce with excretions from cells or from glands in their own bodies. So there's less wax required in this honeycomb, just like in your 3D printer. So they actually don't start off with hexagons. There's a few neat processes that produce the hexagons that we might see. So I'll have Nancy give me a hand here, and I'll show you guys using these straws, which you can see all these straws piled together are nice and round, just like a honeybee would start its cells in its hive. And Darwin was the first one to suggest maybe they start with round cells, and then a few processes result in these nice hexagon shapes. So they'll pile them one next to the other, nice and tight, just like these, and then the bees will actually heat up the wax by using their body heat. They'll heat them up right to 45 degrees Celsius, just like we're heating up these straws.
Not quite 45, Jenny.
And if you take a look closely, you'll see also that with these circles, there's a bit of space in between each cell, which is not great. We want to maximize that space the best we can. So as Nancy's heating them, you'll see they're changing shapes. So if I show you this side, which we've heated and allowed to cool, you can see that once we heated them up, not only did they come closer together as they became more malleable, but we've got hexagons now. So the surface tension of all these cells squishing one next to the other will produce this hexagon shape, just like honeybees do in their hive.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, and there's other cool stuff they do. They also build these beautiful cells at a slight angle. So they build them between 9 and 14 degrees, kind of upright, and that's so that when they fill them with honey, the honey doesn't drip right out, which is pretty brilliant.
That's really cool.
Yeah, and they also build each cell to have walls of the same thickness. So they're also using all of that wax as efficiently as possible, just like your 3D printer. So that's a great example of how technology sometimes imitates things that we see in the natural world, like beehives.
That's awesome. Thanks, Jenny.
You're welcome.